Sometimes you walk through things. Amen. But you know what? Amen. When I get out of the spout where the glory's coming out, the devil better look out. Amen. Because we're gonna get on him. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Take your teeth out. What
are
we gonna do?
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. The rock getting tuned up here. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Let's all sing this. We probably all about on this song. Amen.
Sinner come, Jesus Christ, is there
You love them. How you know you passed from death into life, church? Because you love your brother. Amen. Egypt was once my home. I was a slave. Help runs and sin did grow. But like a craven when I looked up to heaven's known, Christ came to save. I'm living.
Oh my God.
talking about? Well, he took me my problem out, and he turned me and walked around. He said, Moses, take your shoes off, you're on holy ground. I heard him say,
I said he would sing down fire, send me down to Elijah, 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 send me down to Elijah I'm not
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Sometimes we just gotta march just a little bit for the Lord. Amen. If you need something from God. Amen. I believe a church service like a bank account. Amen. You can't get nothing out if you don't put nothing in. Amen. Amen. But you put just a little bit in, amen. Like priming a pump, amen. You put a little bit of water in, man, you go prime that pump before you know it. Water going everywhere. Amen. Amen. You say, maybe we do sing this song a little bit. I don't know. Amen. But I'm gonna do what the Lord has me do, amen. Obedience is better than sacrifice. The Lord told Joshua, said, go to Jericho and to mark 7 times the ground. He followed safely, obeyed the Lord's command, and the walls came tumbling down. Thank you. Joshua. He said, go to Jericho and to march 7 times. He followed safely, obeyed the Lord's command, and the walls came tumbling down. And those walls came tumbling down. Joshua marched 7 times around, and those walls came tumbling down, and the walls came tumbling down.
Oh, God.
don't preach the way we used to preach. We don't preach the way we used to preach. We don't preach the way we used to preach. Oh, Charlie, what's the matter now? We can't shout the way we used to shout.
I see, Mama, I call, and I see, and I see, Mama, I call. I
He said, submit yourself to God, resist the devil, and he will flee. Amen. The first part is what we got to do, is submit to God. Amen. Resisting the devil will be the easy part after we submit to God. Amen. Because he'll take care of all our battles.
Amen. I'm kind of hard. Thank you.
few more, church. More days. Amen. Thank you, brother. You had to holler at me sometimes. That's why a lot of times I can't get music up through that, but Amen. I just want to hear the trumpet sound. You know? Amen, bro. You know, that's good today. We can come in, visit one another, what we do, and, you know, and keep your shoes off, make yourself at home, because we're brothers and sisters, and we're going to spend eternity together. Amen. Amen. We're going to be in the same heaven. Ain't that good? Amen. All of us, brothers and sisters, too. Amen. Ain't it good to be in the house of the Lord, church? I tell you, I love Jesus tonight. Amen. Everything I do, amen, and everything, that move that we make is because of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
We do for Him, and
I guarantee you, amen, if you just do a little for Him,
amen, He'll do a whole lot for you.
Amen.
He already has. Amen. Done a whole lot for me. He saved me when I was lost and dying without a Savior.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. He reached way down.
Yeah.
Got a hold of me. Took this old black heart and washed it in red blood and made it white and snow.
Amen.
I still don't know how He does it. Amen. Amen. I can't explain it, but He said if you be born again of the water and the Spirit. And how you born again? Because you're starting all over.
Amen.
Amen. We're starting all, when we start all over with Jesus, amen, it's just a wonderful, wonderful thing, wonderful life. Amen. I heard a preacher say one time, he said, I don't know how a brown cow eats green grass and gets white milk either, but it does. Amen. You can't explain it, but God knows, don't He? Amen. Never let us down. Amen. He's always on time, every time. Amen. Anybody else got a song or a testimony for me? Amen. We break the bread. Amen. Anybody welcome. Amen. Listen, it's all time belongs to the Lord. Thank God for these fellas helping us up here and the ladies that sing and stuff. And I tell you, we're a body. We're not one person. We're a body in Christ. Amen. Everybody that's got the Lord Jesus as your personal Savior, amen, we're brothers and sisters.
Amen.
And we're in the body.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. You want to sing one, Bo? Come on. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Listen, while he's getting ready, let's all stand on our feet. We can take your time, Bubba. Bubby's got the Brother Bubby. Terry, we call him Bubby. No, Bubby does sing. Everybody calls him Bubby. Amen. Pray over it, boys. Amen. In the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord. Amen. 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 She's wanting to stand in line. You girls come up and anoint your hands. There will be that 3-in-1 oil on you.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Father, Son, Holy Ghost. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Pass some right around, Kayla. Amen. Amen. Let's. Amen. Anoint them with oil, the Bible says. Amen. Call for the elders of the church. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Lay hands on her in the name of Jesus.
Lord, we believe, God, that you can do anything. Go ahead, brother. Bless her, Lord. Touch her, Jesus. She's standing in the gap, God. We ask you, Lord, to touch her. Lord, to heal their bodies. You know everything, Lord. Save their soul if they're lost, Lord. We know, God, that you're able to do anything we ask.
Touch him, Lord.
Amen. Let's give the Lord a big
praise. Praise the Lord. Amen. I'd like saying something to you tonight. Amen.
Amen.
I was up early this morning. I had a thought on my mind, and it seemed like every time that I have a thought, amen, God changes it. Amen. But I was up about 2 o'clock this morning, and something went through my head when I went to look, and God... Amen. Brought this to my mind. Amen. Let's turn to John 10:10 if you want to follow with me. This scripture. Everybody knows this scripture? Amen. You've heard it a bunch of times. Amen. Y'all pray for the preacher tonight, are you?
Amen.
Amen. I tell you, a little amen, a little help him, Lord, that goes a long way with me. Trying to preach the word of the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. We said, well, you pastor, you've been preaching 20-some years. Yeah, it don't matter. Amen. I'll be honest with you, I still get nervous when I go to break bread. Why? You know what? We should fear the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Because what we say, we're going to answer for. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Let me find it again with my magnifier. 10:10 said, the thief cometh not but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that you might have life, and he might have it more abundantly. It's the only scripture I'm going to read. Amen. But I want you to look over at your neighbor and say something tonight. Because if I could tie a knot, something. Amen. If I could title this tonight, amen. Some people do, some people don't. But it'd be the enemy is closer than you think. Amen. That's what, if I could title this tonight, that's what it'd be. Now, I read from the New Testament, and the enemy, amen, the Bible always tells me that you don't fight against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers and rulers of darkness in high places. Amen. And the Bible also says, amen, that your brother's not your enemy. Amen. But I'll tell you who your enemy is. That's the devil. Amen. Amen. How many of you believe there's a devil? Amen. Listen, if you believe in God, you're going to have to believe there's a devil, because there's both in the word of the Lord. Amen. But anyway, when I got to reading and I got to studying last night a little bit, Hezekiah. Anybody know who Hezekiah was? Amen. Hezekiah was the one that was sick. Amen. And Hang on just a second. We're going to turn some mics off here or something. I'm starting to squeal. Amen. My voice is about to go, so y'all go ahead and pray for me. Amen. But anyway, Hezekiah was the one that was sick and was going to die. Amen. And he began to pray. And anyway, y'all remember what happened? The story about Isaiah went back and gave him 15 years to live. Amen. But after that it happened, amen, this king, amen, of, let me get this right down pat here. I'm going to read it. Amen. Hang on 1 second. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to get this place exactly right because, amen, this is in Isaiah. Amen. But listen, the king of Babylon. Amen. If you want to read this, I'll show you where it's at later. But anyway, this story of Hezekiah and what had happened, he got healed, and the king, amen, of Babylon had heard, amen, about him being sick, and then he got healed. Amen. So he sent some letters, amen, to Hezekiah. Amen. And when he went along with the letters, he sent him a present. Amen. He sent him some gifts, in other words. And he sent him a present and he sent him some letters. Amen. That he had got over his sickness. Amen. And when this happened, he sent some messengers with him. Here come old Hezekiah, and he led him right into his house. He led him into the storehouses and he showed him everything he had. Gotta watch out, amen, because the devil, he'll try to slip you a good little letter in there. He'll try to slip you, amen, a little gift, amen, to get you to do something maybe you shouldn't do.
Amen.
Amen. You know what? The devil, listen, he'll come in. He'll say, look over on the other side. That grass is greener over there than it is over here. I ain't gonna tell you something. When you get over there, it's not gonna be astroturf. Amen. It's not gonna be something that you can't eat. Come on, somebody. Be careful, the enemy is closer than you think, amen. Hezekiah brought him in and showed him all the gold and silver he had. Amen. He showed him everything that was all the good things that he had going on in his life. Amen. Hezekiah opened up the doors and let him in.
Amen.
Amen. So be careful. The devil's closer than you think. Don't open up your door and let him in. Amen. Let me tell you something Rick used to tell me all the time. He said, if you give the devil an inch, he'll be a ruler.
Amen.
Didn't he? And he will. He'll become a ruler on you. Amen. Amen. But you know what I was thinking? Here, all of a sudden, here comes Isaiah back. Amen. And he looked, the prophet Isaiah looked at him and said, who was these men anyway? He said, well, they come from a long journey. They come all the way from Babylon. Amen. And they come, amen, here. Amen. And he said, did they see anything here? He said, I showed them everything I got. Uh-oh. Amen. The enemy is closer than we think. Amen. I won't tell you, amen, because he said, this is what thus saith the Lord. He said, everything that you got is going to be taken into Babylon. He said, your sons is going to be eunuchs in the house of the Babylons. Come on, somebody. Amen. You know what? Amen. He was going to lose everything he had. Be careful, because the devil is closer than you think. And then the thief come but to steal, kill, and destroy. Is that what the scripture says?
Amen.
Amen. Listen, what's he wanting to take from us? Amen. I tell you, he will. But you know what? First thing, he'll come in, he'll take your joy.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody. Amen. If we used to shout in the house of the Lord and you ain't shouting in the last month or two, amen, listen to me. Amen. The enemy is closer than you think. He's trying to steal your joy. Amen. We get worried about everything in the world. Amen. We'll worry about this going on in our life, or we'll worry about that. We need to worry about getting a hold of God. Come on. And don't let the devil, amen, in and see what you got. Amen. I don't like to pre-plan a whole lot of things. I ain't got nothing against nobody that does, but I don't like to pre-plan a whole lot. Why? Amen. Because I don't want the enemy to know what we're going to do. Do we set up a song, amen, before we get started? No, we don't. Amen. We get up here, we start beating on these instruments. We start praising the Lord. We let the Lord lead us. Come on, somebody. You say, well, you say it, amen. Ain't no grave. Gonna hold my body down every service.
Amen.
That's because it's true. I can prove it by the Word of God.
Amen.
What's the matter with saying something's true every service? Because there ain't no grave going to hold my body down. What are you talking about? Amen. Even way back when Joseph was in Egypt. Am I right or wrong, Rob? He said, look, when y'all leave here, he said, I know y'all's leaving Egypt. He said, y'all's leaving here one of these days. He said, when you do, take my bones with you. Hear me say it, amen? Listen to me, my God ain't going to leave nothing down here. Man. He taking me out of here. In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, this is what Scripture says. At the last trump, the dead in Christ shall rise first. Those who are alive and remain will be called up together to be with the Lord in the air. Amen. Brother, do you believe there's going to be a rapture? There's a lot of people saying, now the Bible don't say rapture. Nope, but it says he's going to come back and get us and take us out of here. That's good enough for me. You can call it rapture, call it away, pray it right out. I don't care what you call it, as long as God calls me. Amen. I'm leaving here. I heard something.
Come on.
Probably my get filled. I get to stomping around. Amen. Ain't God good?
Oh,
yes. Devil's closer than you think. Be careful. Amen. Don't let the enemy in. Amen. Listen, these love will come in and try to tell you everything. Amen. Listen, these eyes will lie to you anyway. Amen, won't they? Amen. It ain't always what you can see that matters. It's what you can't see. Come on. Amen. We can't serve God in the natural. We got to serve him in the supernatural. Amen. He's a supernatural God. I ain't never laid eyes upon the Lord until I look at things. He's made. I can see him through things. Don't get me wrong. Amen. One of these days I will. Come on, somebody. We just got to hold on just a little bit longer.
Amen.
Same story I told you here a while back. Amen. I was telling you a story about Gibeon. Amen. And what they had done. They knew, amen, that God's people had just defeated Jericho. Amen. And they just they went through Jericho. Y'all know we sang about it a minute ago. And the walls, and I know somebody out there is listening to that song saying, look, they don't even know what they're reading. I beg to differ. I know that they went around that city one time for 6 days. And on the seventh day is when they went seven times. So I know, let me tell everybody right now, they went 13 times around that city. Amen. But the last time, amen, they blew the trumpet and they began to shout. Amen. And the walls came down. Amen.
That's right.
Preach it, brother.
Amen. The walls came down. Amen. And y'all, you know, when Gideon heard about it, they knew they was in trouble. They knew that they had went through Jericho, and then they got to Ai. I know they lost the battle once in Ai, but they come back. Amen. And they defeated them the second time. Y'all remember. Amen. Y'all know that they had made a mistake because they was sin in the camp, and they got whooped by Ai. And then when they got things right, amen, they went right through Ai and they was continuing on. Amen. But Gideon heard about it, so they went and got him some old clothes. Went and got him some old shoes. They went and got him some wine bottles that was old and no good. Amen. And they threw them up on their donkeys. Amen. And they rode all the way over, amen, to meet with Joshua. Come on, somebody. They knew they was in trouble. See how the enemy is? Amen. They painted themselves up like they was coming on a long journey.
Yeah.
I'll be honest with you. I read a study Bible that said they was about 15 miles away.
Yeah.
Yeah. Enemy's closer than you think.
Right.
You see?
Come on,
amen. They didn't. Joshua didn't recognize it because they had old shoes on, had their old wine bottles. Amen. Everything looked like it was old. Amen. But it really wasn't. They was only 15 miles away. Amen. But they knew that God's people was a-coming. So they ran over and they made an alliance with Joshua so he wouldn't wipe them out when they come to the next town. Be careful, church, what the devil may look like one thing, but he's another. Be remember what he was. He was one of the prettiest angels in heaven. Come on, somebody. Amen. We got to be careful. Amen. Be careful. The enemy's closer than you think. Listen, if he can get you thinking on one little wrong thing instead of 100 right, the devil's going to get you thinking on that one little wrong thing. Come on. Am I right or wrong? You know what? I seen my pastor, amen, and she had breeches on. Come on, somebody. So do I. No, just what I say. Pastor's wife. You know, they all see one little thing. Come on.
Amen, brother.
What about the 100 right things? You know, Sister so-and-so, I seen her, you know, she was all painted up, looked like a Jezebel. Come on. People making statements. Come on, just a minute. What about all the 100 right things that the sister's doing? She may be down here on the corner feeding one of the street walkers. Come on. And then she may be down here somewhere feeding somebody that's hungry while you're sitting at home talking about her sister. Be careful. The enemy's closer than what you think. Am I right or wrong? Amen. Listen, I got to give a message every now and then to warn the people. Amen. The enemy is closer than you think. Amen. In any way, if you had the Spirit of the Lord within you, amen. Jesus hung around, amen, with the prostitutes. Amen. He hung around with the women, amen, that they didn't like too good. And they got right down and washed his feet with their tears and dried them with their hair. Amen. How many of us would do that? Amen. To a brother. We need to be thinking about something else. Amen. When we see that little lady down here on the corner, amen, you think, well, you know what? That's somebody's daughter. Come on, somebody. Believe me. Amen. My wife, she reminded me. She said, be careful. You're going to get in trouble again. Amen. Because the other day when I was at work, I told my boy, amen, I seen him talking to somebody. And I think me and him got into a few words of discussion, I'll say. Amen. And he, I said, look, I don't want you hanging with trash. I went to work the next day, judging all day long, God's a thumping on this old bald onion of mine. He said, preacher, did I make trash? I said, Lord, forgive me. Amen, this dumb man that I am. Forgive me, Lord. Because you don't make trash. They're just lost. They just need a Savior in their life. Amen. When I got home, I told my wife, I said, is TJ hurt? She said, yeah, he's hurt. I said, I got to talk to him. And I said, look, boy, I said, I got to apologize because God dealt with me all day for what I said to you. I said, look. I said, they're not trash. I said, they're just lost. Amen. Just like he is. Come on, somebody. Amen. That's somebody's children out here. That's somebody's daughter out here. Amen. We need to have the mind of prayer. Amen. He's closer than we think he is. Devil's closer than we think. Amen. So when you come by and you see some alcoholics, amen, parked up mud for it, amen, and this little fellow right here, amen, has got enough God in his life that he don't tell him to leave. But he sits down and says, let me tell you about a man I found, amen, a few Easters ago. Amen. Let me tell you about this Jesus man that I found a few Easters back. Amen. And I don't have to have the bottle no more. Come on, somebody. Amen. We need to have that right. Man is closer than we think. I'm going to be flat dead honest with you. If we don't get that love in our heart, amen, for our brothers and our sisters, amen, listen to me. Amen, if our brother does one thing, amen, somebody might throw a candy wrapper over in their yard and ready to fist or cuff you. Come on. I got some news for you. You don't own that land. God owns it all. Amen. He's going to perish with the rest of this world. Don't fall out over it. Amen. Listen, when we got this place right here, I didn't have a church on it. My brother next door, he's a brother in the Lord. Amen. He said, I don't know exactly where that property line is, but I think it's right. I said, put your fence up, brother. He said, you really don't care, do you? I said, a few inches that will kill us, so we're in the way. Come on, somebody. You think I'm going to fall out and go to hell over a few inches? Come on, somebody. And I don't know anyway. This is going to perish anyway. Come on, somebody. Amen. We forget. Amen. That these things down here are temporary. Amen. But Jesus said, Randy, you lay your treasures up in heaven. Hey! Come on, we're going to think to get them. Amen. Ain't no thief can come in. No moth can corrupt them. No rust. Amen. If I lay them up over there. Amen. I can almost see the lights of home sometimes, brother. Amen. And I see, amen, something that's coming. Amen. I can almost get, you know how it is in the spring. You can smell the rain a coming, Gene. Amen. You can about smell it in the air. I feel something coming. I can just about smell it in the air. Jesus is coming after his church. The devil is closer. The enemy is closer than we know. He is. Amen. Man, we need to get everything prayed up and under the blood. And we need to be looking, amen, for Jesus to come. Amen. Listen. Amen. We need to be watching. Amen. And praying because he's coming in an hour that we think not. Amen. If you can't look around, he told them all the time. He said, you know, these are having the ear, let him hear what the Spirit says unto the churches. Amen. Listen, we need to listen. Amen. And see what's going on in this world. Amen. Our country's turned upside down.
Amen. Come
on, brother. Amen. The enemy thinks he's got us. Amen. He's a liar. I wasn't born again yesterday. Come on, somebody. It's been a little while. I've learned a few things. Amen. I got a few battle scars. Amen. And I can tell the sheep, look out. Amen. Because that old enemy's closer than what we think. Amen. You know what he does? Amen. Sometimes he'll put on a sheep's clothes. Amen. You know how that old cartoon used to be? That old coyote.
Yeah.
Is that who it was? I don't know. And he punched that cock. You remember that one? And the other old sheepdog, he had it down over his face. And that old wolf thought he had him. And then just because he had a little bit of hair down over his eyes, let me tell you something, devil, I wasn't born again yesterday. It may look like I got a little hair down over my eyes, but I see these sheep, and he better keep his hands off them.
Amen.
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 Great, brother.
I love the Lord, brother. My God, ain't he good, ain't you? Amen. Ain't nothing like Jesus. Ain't nobody can do me like Jesus does.
Right.
Man, they put on, they done the same thing. You know, they put on all these old clothes, had all these things looking old, went up to him and said, man, we come from a far journey. Amen. They was lying to Joshua all the time, but they made an alliance with him so he wouldn't kill him. Amen. Let me tell you something. Don't let the devil lie to you. You tell him, you say, ask for me. Stand in the middle of your living room. Sometimes they throw your hands up when things look like it's going bad. You throw them hands in there and say, ask for me in my house. We're going to serve the Lord. Amen. You can't lie to me. Amen. And tell me that my brother or my pastor don't love me no more. You're a liar.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
He thinks because, amen, sometimes we ain't saying a whole lot and we don't see a whole lot. Amen. Let me tell you something. Me and my wife be talking. And I say, do you see this? Or you know who's stepping up? Or you see this going on? Yeah, I see it. Man, we talk about it all the time. Amen. Listen to me. I don't bring your name up all the time in church. But when your butt ain't deceived, I see it. Come on, somebody. And this church needs everybody. Come on, amen. We need every world body. Amen. And we can't hardly function without a big toe. Amen. Yeah, we're out of bounds. We can't run fast. Amen. Ain't God good? Enemies to kill, steal, and destroy. Amen. Let me tell you something. Samson, y'all remember how anointed he was? Amen. My God, what an anointed man. I often thought about, man, he took killed 1,000 men with a jawbone.
Yep.
Well, I tell you, you get 3 or 4 of us and stand one man out there and see if he can defend all 3 or 4 of them. It'd be hard. I don't care if he's got a jawbone or a ball back. Come on, somebody. Somebody's going to get in and get a punch in. You said, no, not when you're anointed by God. Amen. Samson killed 1,000 with a jawbone. Come on, and often, man, it just amazed me when he caught them 300 foxes. Amen. It always did. Amen. Because he had to be on the rock. Why catch one fox? You see what I'm saying? That was a hard one, wasn't it? Miracle. Amen. And Kathy, I'll never forget the message. I feel foxy. Amen. She preached the whole message good. Amen. But you know what? You think of that. How anointed he was. Amen. He had that man, he would shake himself. The power of the Lord would come upon him. The devil better look out. Amen. Because he was anointed. Amen. But here come Delilah. Amen. You know what? It wasn't representing how women are. It was representing the enemy. Amen. Somebody was coming to steal, kill. kill and destroy him. Amen. It wasn't that it was a woman. It's just like Jezebel. The people want to think we don't call women. Let me tell you something. That wasn't even talking really about the woman as much as what it was representing. She was serving a false god. Amen. And she was trying to entice the man of God. It was a spirit that she had. Amen. It was the thing upon her that was moving. God could have saved her. Amen. Just as much as he could have saved anybody else. If you want him to.
Amen.
Amen. You don't get too big, too mean, too ugly for my Lord to say. Look at me. I'm kidding. We all be able to laugh. Amen. I'd rather see you showing them pearly whites, wouldn't you, brother? As a sack puss, you know, the pickle puss face running around with your head hanging out. Come on, somebody. We're born again Christian. The enemy is closer than you think. Amen. She kept on. I often wonder, how dumb could you be? Anybody ever think about that? Because she tried and tried several times. He even looked at her once. He said, you'd have never got that riddle I had if you hadn't been, what was it, plowing with my heifer, plowing with his, huh? Remember? What? What the Bible said. Amen. So you're saying, you see what I'm saying? I'm saying, man, how dumb could you be? Samson, man, come on, wake up. You know what? We're the same way. What are you talking about? We let the devil come in and trick us time and time again. Steal our joy, steal our salvation. We let a man or a woman steal our salvation. Come on, somebody. Am I right or wrong? Let me tell you something. There's one scripture people say, well, you know, you are. Be married until you die. People say things like that and stuff like that. And let me tell you something. It says what God has joined together, let no man put asunder. But ain't ever marriage put together by God.
Amen.
You see what I'm saying?
Amen.
Some of them, other things put marriages together. Amen. Listen, when you get right and God's got you both in the right situation, you will stay together.
Amen.
Come on!
Yeah.
Where'd that come from? I don't know. Don't let the enemy is trying to get too close to you.
Yep.
Come on, somebody. Don't let him come in and steal, kill, and destroy you. Don't let your mind be thinking about them things more than it's thinking about what God's wanting you to do.
Amen.
That's free. It don't cost you a dime. Amen. Come on, somebody. I'm trying to help you. Amen. Am I right or wrong? Amen. If I'm wrong, you tell me, shut up, sit down, preacher. And I still go, well, I ain't going to shut up, sit down. Probably till God tells me to, but I'm. Amen. Bless him for saying that, Brother Billy. Amen. Thank God. I like to see him smiles on your face. Amen. Look, we're trying to help you. Amen. The enemy is closer than what you think. Amen. Because old Samson, he didn't know no better. Amen. Evidently, and you know what? Don't think nothing, because I thought the same thing. God says, you know, don't you ever make mistakes? I say, yes, Lord, I have. Amen. Amen. So here, amen. Finally, the lady's head right in her lap. Amen. And I got in trouble one time because she cut his anointing off. She didn't. She called for the men to come in, and they did. Amen. He had seven locks that hung. Amen. And you know why? Because it was a vow that he had taken. Amen. They didn't cut their hair. Seven Nazarites didn't do that. Amen. And he had seven locks, and his anointing was with him, but to a lady's head in the lap of Delilah. Amen. And she cut his locks off.
Yeah.
You say, well, see, that woman done it. No, it was representing the enemy. And be careful, because we'll lay our hand right in the devil's lap, and he'll cut off our anointing. Amen. 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 Real careful. Amen. Come on, somebody. Amen. Amen. Bless him for sitting down, Billy said. Amen. But Samson, the enemy was closer than what appeared, than what he seen. Amen. Be careful, church.
Amen.
Your anointing is important.
Amen.
Amen. The anointing is what destroys the yoke.
That's right.
You say, well, brother, I ain't anointed. Let me tell you something. You made me anointed in praying. Amen. We need more prayer warriors. Amen. I was telling somebody before church, I said, look, getting up here and preaching, amen, is easy compared to preaching out on the road.
Yeah.
Amen. Out here in the highways and hedges, compelling them to come in. I think it's a little bit easier up here, amen, to get at the workplace and preaching the Word of God. Come on, somebody. Telling people about Jesus when they're not wanting you to say it, when they don't want to hear it. Amen. And you're still saying it. Hey, man, my God. You know what? That's a great work. Being a prayer warrior is a great work. We need more people praying. Amen. Getting a hold of God. Amen. For our leaders. Amen. Of our countries. Amen. For our preachers. Amen. And our teachers. We need God to touch us and anoint us. Amen. And clear us up. Clear our minds. Amen. Clean us up. Spiritual wickedness in high places.
Yeah.
Amen. Man, I've often thought about that too. Be careful.
Yeah.
Spiritual wickedness could be from your pulpits to your White House.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Anyway, that was free too. Amen.
I'm glad it was.
Even Jesus knew his enemy was close.
Yeah.
Come on now.
Yeah.
You know what he told him? He said, the very one, amen, the very one, amen, who betrayeth me. He said, the hand of him that betrayeth me. See, I want to make sure I get it right. The hand of him that betrayeth me is with me on this table.
Amen.
This was at the Last Supper. Amen. When they was all sitting around. Amen. And Jesus was saying, here, amen, this is my body. Amen. Didn't he? And he said, breaking the bread. He said, drink this, because it's my blood that was shed for you. He said, he, amen, that is with me, whose hand is on this table, is going to betray me. I knew the enemy was right there. Amen. What is that? Somebody used to say, keep something and your enemy closer. I couldn't remember what the first part was.
Keep your friends close.
Friends close and your enemies closer. Amen. Jesus knew who was going to betray him. The enemy is closer than you think. Be careful. The enemy can come up and kiss you. Did Jesus? Amen. I ain't going to get whooped for his name. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. My brother Junior Markham, amen. Not, he told me the story one time. It's gone on to be with the Lord. Amen. Junior told me, he said, there's some people out wanting to whoop him one time. One of them had a club, amen. Junior said, he come out and he said, look, that fella had that club. He said, you know what? You can't whoop me in God, too. Well, the fella down dropped his club and walked off. Come on, somebody. You see what I'm saying? Amen. The anointing destroys the yoke. Don't let the enemy in too close to you.
Amen.
Amen. Think about it. Amen. I still don't think it was, amen, Bathsheba's fault that she was out taking a bath. I think it was David's fault for not being out fighting a war and looking down at her taking a bath. Come on, somebody. The enemy's too close. We're not going to get in too close. Clear us up, God. Clean us up, God. Sanctify us, Lord. Amen. Keep us good and clean, God, because I know you're coming after the church is washed pure and white in the blood of the Lamb. Amen. Now, I know people out there say, boy, all that preacher speaks about today. Amen.
Come on, brother.
All he's preached about today. Well, we need to talk. Amen. Because he's in there too. Be careful. Amen. He will get you. Amen. Listen, I'm happy in the Lord. Amen. But I'm going to be held accountable one of these days. Amen.
That's
right. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to tell you something. All I've preached about is the enemy. But that was the first part of that verse. Did y'all notice that? Huh? He said, the thief cometh, but to steal, kill, and destroy. He said, but I come that you may have life and have it more abundantly. You see that? Hey, I've been warning you about the enemy being close. Amen. But let me tell you something. Jesus said that I come that you may have life and have it more abundantly. Amen. Listen, I'm alive in Christ Jesus. Amen. And I tell you what, I know. Amen. That I'm living this life more abundantly because I know he supplies every need I got. Amen. I'm not gloom and doom. Amen. Listen to me. Amen. I'm born again on the way to heaven. This journey just gets good and good every day. Whoa! devil knows me, and I know him. Amen. He better watch. Amen. Because God gave me power over him. Amen. Listen to me. Devil knows scriptures. Amen. And a lot of things. Amen. He'll throw him out there at you left and right. Amen. But I ain't worried scripture. Amen. Are you? I don't argue. Amen. I got love in my heart. Amen. Listen, if we get the Lord right in our heart, we ain't going to argue scripture. Amen. We're going to pray about him. We're going to tell each other we love one another. Amen. Because love will cover a multitude of sins. Amen. Come on, somebody. Charity will. Amen. Cover a multitude of sins. Amen. Amen. Listen, you better feel it here because God ain't here. Amen. Am I right or wrong? Amen. I've heard that story time and time again about the fellow sitting outside. You know, here come this little drunk man in. He had been drinking a little bit or something, a little rough looking guy. You know, and somebody, I guess one of the deacons probably went back and said, "You're going to have to leave, bro. You know, you're in our church. You're disrupting our church, you know, or something." And then the fellow walked outside, and there was another guy outside. He said, "Man," he said, "can you believe them people made me leave? They won't let me come in." He said, "Don't worry." He said, "I'm God. They won't let me in either." Come on, somebody. Amen. Amen. People say, you know, oh, well, Jesus, listen, Jesus made it tougher. He's come to fulfill the law, but he made it a little bit harder. Amen. Especially on one. People talk about adultery. It's adultery. They don't know what's going on. Jesus said, if you look upon a woman and lust after her in your heart, you've done committed adultery in your heart.
Amen.
Lust after her, you've done committed adultery in your heart. Did I say that right? Amen. That's a little bit tougher. Amen. People say, well, you ain't going to hold an office in this church. Listen, the enemy's closer than what they even think. Amen. They said, because you got more than one wife. I said, brother, how many wives you got anyway? I'm only married to her. Well, you got one wife. You see, people take it all wrong when they read the scripture when it said be the husband of one wife. They think, amen, that they're talking about, well, he's been divorced. No, he didn't say that. Back then, they'd have 50 wives.
Yeah.
Amen. But he was saying be the husband of one. Come on. How many you got, Rick?
One.
Amen. Amen. See how I mean? The enemy gets close and people don't even realize it. He gets right in there and puts blinders over you. Can't see what's going on. Come on, somebody. Am I right or wrong? Amen. Love will cover a multitude of sins. Amen. If we love one another. Amen. Tell me all the time, he said, if I can't teach you nothing, I want to teach you one thing. Amen. I'll teach you loving one another. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
All is well.
All is well. Amen. All is well. Amen. If the enemy gets too close for you, submit yourself to God. Be submitted. Committed. Prayed up. Fired up. Ready to go up. Amen. At all times. Amen. Because the enemy is out here. He comes to kill, steal, and destroy. My sister Jean, amen, her thing in here, the bookmark where she passed away. And I think, oh, man, she used to say that all the time. She used to say, look, the enemy comes to kill, steal, and destroy. The thief comes to steal, kill, and destroy. She knew he was the enemy.
Amen.
Amen. Ain't God good?
Oh,
God. Amen. I'm about to shut up here. Where's my girls? You got a baby putting a diaper on. Amen.
I'm
Everybody love the pastor.
Amen.
Amen. I feel like I'm trying to give you something to heal you. Amen. And to help you. Amen. Because the enemy is closer than we think. Amen. You know why? Because it's the last days. Amen. I believe that. Amen. He's trying everything he can do. Amen. He'll turn one church member against the other. Amen. He'll do everything like that. Amen. Trying to get us, amen, into a place, amen, where we'll say, well, I don't even want to go to church no more. Amen. If you're finding it a chore to come to church, look out. The enemy's closer than you think.
Amen.
You should find it a joy to come to the house of the Lord.
Amen.
David said, I was glad when they said, let us go to the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Boys, come on, grab the instruments if you don't care.
Amen. Amen. I got another song I tried a while ago. Amen. Pete sent me. I like to try it. It's an odd song.
Probably won't sing it
right, to be honest with you. But I want somebody to listen to the words of this song. Amen. I'd like to try this. No, you have to flip it. Amen. I got on 2 pages. Y'all listen to the words. Pete sent me this, and I'll be honest with you, man, the words are really good. Nope. Let's try another one.
Okay.
Amen. Amen. I heard this one too. And a while back. You know, I know that he done it for everybody. Amen. But we need to put ourselves in that position and say, you know what? Jesus done that for me. Everything he done. There lays the crown that fell from his head. Oh, the blood is dry.
And I'm the reason for
walked every mile just for you. Throat's back now. Amen. People on that live feed, they send in requests.
Was it glory?
Man, ain't y'all fine. Amen. So let me sing. I'll give it a whirl. If I can remember the words, God, I ain't got it written down. It's been a long time. Amen. You can take. In God we trust. Off the courthouse wall, you can even take on the manger scene out of our parts and home. You can take my blessed Bible, tear the pages all apart. You can never take. But you can't take away that precious life he gave. You can never save my soul from hell. You can take my place in my heart and tear the pages all apart. You can never take my Jesus. God's holy word. You can even say, you can stop our boys from preaching in the streets or in the park. You could never take my Jesus. But you can't take away that blessed life he gave. You can never save my soul from hell. You can take my blessed Bible and turn the pages all apart. You could never take my Jesus. Amen. You feel like,
tonight at 6 o'clock,
amen, that you got a tug at your heart. Amen.